excited this morning to come out and worship here with us. If you have your Bibles, let's open them to the Gospel of John. John chapter 8. John chapter 8. We're actually going to pick up reading in verse 38 through 47. John 8:38, we find these words, "I speak of what I have seen with my Father, and you do what you have heard from your Father." They answered him, "Abraham is our father." Jesus said to them, "If you were Abraham's children, you would be doing what Abraham did. But now you seek to kill a man who has told you the truth that I heard from God. This is not what Abraham did. You are doing what your father did." They said to him, "We were not born of sexual immorality. We have one father, even God." Jesus said to them, "If God were your father, you would love me, for I came from God, and I am here. I came not of my own accord, but he sent me. Why do you not understand what I say? It is because you cannot bear to hear my word. You are of your father the devil, and your will is to do your father's desires. He was a murderer from the beginning and has nothing to do with the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks of his own character, for he is a liar and the father of lies. But because I tell you the truth, you do not believe me. Which one of you convicts me of sin? If I tell you the truth, why do you believe me? Why do you not believe me? Whoever is of God hears the words of God. The reason why you do not hear them is that you are not of God." Let's pray. Father, we come before you today. We are thankful to have this time together here in your house to minister, O God, and be ministered to. And we thank you for the specials we have here today and just the good reports we receive of answered prayer. And to be able, Lord, to meet with our brothers and sisters in Christ. But Father, you know that in a crowd this size, there's possibly someone here today who is unsure of their eternal destiny. Unsure that if they were to die this very moment, they would hear God say, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant." Maybe there's someone here today that is struggling in temptation. Maybe someone here, Father, is in the valley of life. And they just need to be uplifted and encouraged. And we pray that the Holy Spirit may do that today through the Word. And that you, O God, alone will get all the praise and the glory as you move in our presence. And we'll give you that rightful place in this service. For we pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. All of God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. Well, last week, if you remember, as we looked at this passage of Scripture, we saw Jesus telling those who had heard his message just prior, which was being preached on during this Feast of the Tabernacles, he had told them that you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Last week, we looked at how the truth is not just dry facts. It's not 1 + 1 = 2, but the truth is a person who is Jesus. Remember, he went on to say, "I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life." So Jesus told this crowd last week in this passage, if you know me, you can be free from all of your sin. He also told them that it was their sin that held them captive. It was their sin that held them in bondage. And the only way to be set free from those addictions, from those things that continually pull us in the wrong direction, is by having a relationship with Jesus Christ. He made it very clear there was no other way. Now, in this passage that we read here today, I've titled the message, "Jesus Knows." Jesus Knows. In 1895, there was a song written that is in our hymnals here today. It says, "There is not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. None else can heal all our soul's diseases. No, not one." And then that song goes on, and I want you to hear this. He says in that song, "Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. And I believe that that song hits the nail right on the head when he says, Jesus knows all about our struggles. As we read this passage of Scripture, we don't want to get off of focus, because remember that John wrote this gospel for a very particular reason. And that reason was that you and I might believe that Jesus is the Christ. Now that word Christ is the same Hebrew word that meant Messiah. That Jesus is the Messiah. So as we read through this passage here today, we have to keep in mind that John is trying to show us here that Jesus is who he claimed to be. He is God in flesh. And remember here, as he's talking to this crowd, they claim to be Abraham's children. They say, we are of Abraham. Abraham is our father. And Jesus says, no, if Abraham were your father, you would be doing the things that Abraham did. You know, oftentimes when you're out in public, it's fun to watch people. You ever done that? It's a good pastime. Just to sit and watch people. And as you're sitting there watching people, I like to watch kids with their parents. Because a lot of times, a large majority of the time, the kid will have mannerisms that the parent has. You know, if you see a child who's out in public and they're very loud, they talk very loud, a lot of times that's the way things are at home. That, you know, they just copy those things. That's what Jesus is saying here. He is saying to them, no, you're not Abraham's children because you do not do the things that Abraham did. Jesus was saying, there is a problem with your profession because your actions do not verify what you say. And then they tried to give Jesus what we might call a cheap shot there in verse 41. They began discrediting him. They said, we're not born of sexual immorality. Probably Jesus' ministry is getting to the point at this time that talk has begun to go through the town that Mary wasn't really a virgin and that Jesus had been born in a sexually immoral relationship. So they try to throw that out there to Jesus, but he doesn't even talk about that. Instead, he goes right on and tells them, there is no way that God is your father. Because if God were your father, you would be practicing love, because God is love. What I want you to see this morning, to be able to grasp from this passage, I want you to see that Jesus is showing them that he is omniscient. That means that he is all-knowing. And there is only one all throughout history who has ever had the attribute of being all-knowing, and that is God himself. But Jesus is showing these Jews that he knows them better than they know themselves. Not only does he know them, but he knows the Father, and he knows Abraham better than they know God, and better than they know Abraham. He is all-knowing. The Bible says in 1 Peter 1:19, but with the precious blood of Christ, as a lamb without blemish and without spot, who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in these last times for you. Peter, in that passage, shows us that Jesus Christ has always been. He is all-knowing. He is God in flesh. And there is nothing that God doesn't know. Some things, as we're going through our day, will just occur to us. And we may say, that never occurred to me before. Did you understand and realize that nothing ever just occurs to God?